Today, Phil Spencer and Kirsty Allsop arrived in this London studio.
So it's Phil Star 2.
Yes.
How are you feeling? With their sizzling on-screen chemistry, they've become TV's hottest properties in location, location, location. But how will they handle hosting their own entertainment show?
She was pissed, I could smell Lambrini on her breath.
Let's find out, as it's time for...
A new series of relocation starting this week, and in the first show we're going to be helping a senior city banker relocate to a new home.
It's Kate Moss's 35th birthday this month, and it's great to see her hard partying lifestyle hasn't taken its toll on her looks.
And finally, with the economy predicted to nosedive further in 2009, the government's chief financial advisor is still managing to put on a brave face. OK, let's get on with the rest of the show. Please welcome tonight's band, Glass Vegas!
Ladies and gentlemen. Happy New Year. We should start
happy
by saying
New Year.
Happy New Year, everybody.
Happy New Year.
Let's talk about location, location, location. Hugely successful show. I think it's been going now for 8 years. Over 100 episodes. What is the secret of the show's success, do you think?
Voyeurism.
Everybody's essentially nosy.
Yeah.
And also moving house is something that everybody does or wants to do or...
Yeah. It's voyeurism. It's wanting to see in other people's knicker drawers. You know, metaphorically speaking.
Well, no, I actually do literally like to look in other people's knicker drawers. Do you remember the most disgusting property you ever entered?
Yes.
What was it like? Talk us through
it. We called it the shit flat.
Witty, I like it.
Yes.
The shit flat with the cute fireman. Have you ever seen anything that you weren't meant to, like, you know, like
yes. one of the cameramen once put his camera down on the floor.
The story starts, it was a gay couple, and above the bed there was a mirror, big mirror. And we were stood there doing the view, and we looked up, and there were two handprints in the middle of the mirror. So we kind of stopped and had a bit of a chuckle about it. Imagining what might have gone on to cause the handprint. Yes. As we were laughing, a cameraman had put the camera down on the floor by the bed.
And suddenly the director, who's got the monitor, you know, hanging around the neck, goes, oh, my God, like that. And the camera's still, you know, showing what it's seeing, and it's under the bed. And she's looking at the monitor.
And what did she see under the bed?
Well, there was various things.
A sex toy in the shape of a cucumber.
A sex toy in the shape of a cucumber?
Imagine doing a through the keyhole at Boy George's house. The late boy there.
Who lives?
Right, am I just mad, or isn't a sex toy in the shape of a cucumber just a cucumber? Why make a sex next to it in the shape of a cucumber. Just buy a cucumber.
And the credit crunch is on. It's cheaper. You get 45p for a half one.
Phil, is it true that because of the credit crunch, Channel 4 are cutting back and have actually merged Location, Location, Location with another of its most successful shows?
That's right. We've brought along a preview of the show. Take a look at this.
Alan does it with Justin after a workout in the gym. Justin does it with Alan after playing mixed doubles. Desperate House Hunting Wives is sponsored by Verbal Essences.
Do my crack. Oh. Do my crack.
It was an afternoon like any other on Credit Crunch's Cereal Lane. The Desperate House Hunting Wives were all playing cards and drinking at 4 in the afternoon.
Bree, I can't believe Britain's biggest mortgage lenders have ignored calls from the government to pass on the cut in interest rates to struggling homeowners.
I know, Gabby. The base rate's in its lowest form of
Yes, the house market is in such a slump. Anyway, more margaritas, girls?
Oh, yes, dear. That'll be lovely.
Carlos, get in here, please.
Here are your margaritas, girls.
Such a fucking moron. So drinks are served on the floor.
Anyway, do you know there's a new neighbour in town? A real troublemaker. Sure to annoy everyone, drive us all mad.
Really? Who is he?
He's the foremost mortgage expert in the whole country.
That must be him now. Come in.
What's that?
Let's talk about the fact that you are sex symbols. You really are.
Well, and you too. Both
well,
of you.
Thank
no,
you.
You're more sex symbol. How does that make you feel though when that people at home might be watching, like licking their lips, touching themselves?
Do you remember that, Phil? We did have a guy who was asked for my autograph, and then his wife said, he's such a fan, he videos it and watches it in the middle of the night.
Oh, no.
But, no, it's very flattering.
Is it true, though, that you posed nude when you were younger?
For an artist friend, yes. Not for photos, for a drawing.
Oh, what was your pose? Was it like the two jugs and, like, an orange? Or a cucumber?
I think I was... Lying on the floor.
Lying on the floor?
Yeah.
Face up or face down?
Why don't we have a look? We've got it.
You've got it.
Look at that. You're not the only ones to have posed nude. Well, I say only ones. I mean, I don't know whether you've ever posed nude, Phil, have you?
I haven't, actually.
Would you like to?
No.
Take a look at this. Christy, have a good look, love. Christy, honestly, have a look. It's artistic. No, Christy, honestly, literally, take it in. Feast your eyes.
I told you to lock that dressing room door.
Have you looked at it yet, Christy?
That'd be great. Says me getting one of me five a day.
After the break, we'll be showing a preview of the latest amazing Channel 4 drama to hit our screens.
And we'll be doing the Sunday Night News with Alan. See you then.
Welcome back to the Sunday Night Project. I'm Justin Lee Collins. Here's Alan Carr, Phil Spencer and Kirsty Allsop with the Sunday Night News.
Hello, good evening, and welcome to the Sunday Night News. I'm Kirsty Allsop.
I'm Phil Spencer.